So I've been. Somebody sent me some of this Hint Water. I think it was actually Kara, or actually their PR team, and they said it's the number one water at Google and Facebook, and we should try it out. And I did, and I got addicted to it. And so I had to meet the CEO, and that's what we're going to talk about right now. How is she changing the world of water?
I'm Kara Golden, and I'm the founder and CEO of Hint Water. And this is Hint.
Where did you come from?
Where did I come from? So I actually started my career in media way long ago at Time and then CNN. And I moved into a little company called AOL, where I ran their e-commerce initiative for 7 years, actually. And after leaving in 2001, took a couple of years off, and realized during that time that I had a huge addiction to a company,
In Atlanta?
in
Because
Atlanta, and
I have the same addiction,
a
or I
product that
did.
has a diet word on the label, and I was drinking a significant amount of that product every day, and I didn't have diabetes or obesity or any of the issues that sometimes are talked about today, but really a bad stomach. And I finally decided I needed to kick my Diet Coke habit, and I tried to drink plain water, and I was very bored by water, so started looking for a product that helped me to drink water. And I couldn't find a product that didn't have sweeteners in it.
You've seen them, the vitamin waters and stuff like that. It has a lot of sugar in it, right?
Correct. So when we started this company 9 years ago, Vitamin Water was kind of the big company that that I looked to sort of help me drink more water. And what I realized is that Vitamin Water wasn't water at all. It actually, at that time, had more calories in it than even a can of Coke. And it was. They later moved to add things like stevia and Splenda to the product to reduce the calories. But I was really looking to move away from sweet because I realized that if I moved away from sweet, that was closer to water, and it actually helped me with what I was consuming with the rest of the food, not only the drinks, but also the food. And ultimately, it just helped me get healthier.
Yeah, my wife and I have been trying to cut down carbs, and she's lost 40 pounds. I've lost 15 pounds
That's awesome.
just by doing that. No
Yeah.
exercise.
Yeah.
Still, carbs includes alcohol, so that's cutting down there, and this helps. I love meeting entrepreneurs who are match my TechCrunch poster. I have a poster on my wall drawn by Hugh McLeod, and it says, I'm not delusional, I'm an entrepreneur. And it seems
Love
like
it.
it would be delusional to go into such a crowded space of drinks and soft drinks and waters and stuff like that. You go to a grocery store and you see, I don't know, 50 brands you would have to choose from,
More than that.
right?
Yeah.
And so, why do you think you can,
How and why? Yeah.
how did you get to this place where you got all the Facebookers and Googlers using it?
Well, first of all, I never started off my life by saying I'm going to be a beverage entrepreneur. I sort of fell into this, and it really started to happen when I started to look at my own life and realize that
How long ago was that? And that
9 years ago,
so 9 years
and
ago.
realized that not only the beverages that I was putting into me, but also the food I was putting into me was really not allowing me to be the best that I could be. And not only from a weight perspective, but also from a being able to think clearly perspective. And ultimately, I thought, what am I doing with my own life? And I have young kids, and they've grown up a little bit more now, but I thought, I don't want them to be on this path where they are really looking at food and beverages to make them happy. And so that's sort of where this came from. And ultimately, by I think the first 2 years of this company, I was really in denial about what, about actually being a beverage executive. And again, I came from tech, and so I really, many people in tech back then were like, what are you doing? What are you doing with this beverage company? And I thought, if I can go and disrupt an industry that I see, and it doesn't matter if other people don't see it, as broken. And every day I continue to see how these companies are not only broken, but in my viewpoint, poisoning the world. If I can change that and I can help people get healthier, which is what we hear from consumers every day we're doing, then that's awesome. I mean, we're not just a beverage company that's out to sell beverages, but we're a beverage company that has a social conscience to actually help people get healthier.
And tell me about the early days of you making this product and playing with it in your kitchen.
So
you told me when I met you, you just played with it in your kitchen.
We were boiling fruit down over the stove, and my husband, who was at Netscape and was an attorney there, we were he had left Netscape as well during the AOL acquisition, and the two of us were on the stove making the stuff and producing bottles of Hint. And you know, honestly, our first store was Whole Foods in San Francisco, and I thought it was kind of a game to see, can I actually get a physical product on the shelf at Whole Foods? And I had always been in, you know, a tech sort of space kind of selling environment versus a physical product. So I thought it was really exciting that I could actually sell this product to a store and other humans would like it. And they associated, their life was very much like I was living, that they were looking for a product that was going to make them healthier too. And
tell me about that first sale. How did you get the,
because I
know how hard it is to convince somebody to do something they haven't done before, right?
Absolutely. Well, I got very lucky in taking it to Whole Foods on Franklin in California in San Francisco, and I said, how do I bottle a product that you guys are gonna sell? And the gentleman there told me I needed to have a UPC code, I needed to, you know, have a shelf life, of these things that were totally foreign to me. I'm not, you know, I didn't come from a food background, although my dad actually was in the food background years ago, had launched Healthy Choice for ConAgra. And so I'd always kind of grown up in it, but had sort of shelved that as what he did. And but I had always been sort of sensitive to ingredients. And somewhere along the way, I'd sort of forgotten about that and started drinking this Diet Coke stuff at crazy, crazy levels. But anyway, so got it into Whole Foods.
Tell me about that meeting.
Yeah, so they said,
I want to see
you need a shelf life of at least
I'm sure
6
they...
months. Yeah, no.
I'm sure they looked at you and said, you're crazy.
You're some crazy tech executive who wants a beverage. And I'm like, no, not really. I really just want this product. And actually, it was a funny story. We got it on the shelf at Whole Foods. They said, come back when you have a 6-month shelf life and UPC code and give us some cases and we'll see if it works. So gave them 10 cases, and 2 days later got a phone call from Whole Foods and they said it sold. And I was like, you're kidding. I mean, we've got to produce more product. And we were producing this product in our kitchen. I mean, it was really like bare bones and very, very much an artisan product in the making in our kitchen. And so we produced some more product and got it in there. And my husband's a New Yorker and said, you know, if you're really serious about this, you need to launch it in New York, because if we're going to fail, we're going to know if we're going to fail by bringing it into the New York market. And let's fail fast if we're going to fail. So we launched it in New York as well.
You can make it in New York, you can make it anywhere.
You can make it anywhere. So we launched it in both locations. And then then we actually got a bottler to actually produce the product in a real way. And then just continued to kind of watch it grow and learn the industry, really. Yeah. And the first couple of years, I mean, we really were learning what this was we were doing. I mean, distributors and bottlers and, you know, that the cap is not called a cap, it's called a closure. And so all of these new things. And along the way, I thought, what am I doing? Like, what really am I doing being in the beverage industry? This is really hard. And there's probably 2,000 beverage companies out there in the marketplace. And that really the difference is what we're offering. I mean, we're the leading unsweetened flavored water today in the marketplace. And that's really different.
How does it come? There's coconut water and some other things that are going after sort of the same healthy lifestyle, right? But this product first of all, it tastes good. Where coconut water, I don't like the taste of it. Right?
Yeah. So coconut water has sugar in it. It's mm-hmm. natural sugar. But a very different category. But you know, like that category, we're a totally different category. And actually, in the early days, I called Coke shortly after I saw this working, and I said, I have no idea what I'm doing here, and you guys know what you're doing, and you should really do this product, because I live in San Francisco, and I would buy a lot of this product. And the gentleman that I spoke to on the phone poo-pooed the idea and said, somewhere along the way, honey, Americans like, or actually, sorry, he said, sweetie, Americans like sweet. And I think I didn't even hear anything else he said for the rest of the conversation. I was so like, wow, what did he just say to me? And I thought, wait a minute, I get it. These large beverage companies aren't really interested in providing a product that is healthy and better for you. Yeah. And I thought, if I don't do it, no one's going to do it.
Yeah.
And
they do have distribution muscle, right? I mean, we have Coke here, right?
Absolutely.
And there's Coke literally on every street corner in the world, right?
Yeah.
And that brand is bashed in your head, and they even spend a lot of time on it. They have these new cans that are customized, right?
Customized cans. Yeah. Exactly.
So they have a lot of market power. But I think there's a growing movement. I've keyed in on it with sous vide cookers and other things I'm playing with in my life. That there's a movement of some people who want to get healthier. They're tired of being fat.
Yeah. Well, and I think
and they're tired of drinking the same thing too. I've Diet Coke. I've been drinking it for 45 years, and it tastes bad to me. No.
Right, and many people say it doesn't hydrate them either, and they're trying to stay hydrated. And the interesting thing is, many of our consumers are not overweight. They're not. Some are trying to lose weight. Many are not trying to lose weight. But consistently, these consumers are coming back and saying that they are drinking it for other reasons. So some of the reasons: diabetes, the fact that we're vegan. We use real fruit in our product too. We use the skins and oils of fruit to flavor the product. Most other flavored waters that are out there don't. Mm-hmm. In fact, many of them that say they're fruit water don't even use fruit at all. So that's sort of a whole other topic, which I'm trying to bring more and more awareness to as well, which is that many of the products that are in the marketplace claim to be water, and they're not water at all. So water does not have sweeteners in it, and water doesn't have 62 ingredients in it. Yeah. So I think it really just goes hand in hand with a lot of what's going on in the food movement.
Yeah, you have different kinds. You have mango, grapefruit, and pomegranate. That's my favorite.
The pomegranate one is yummy, and
watermelon water.
Yeah. I'm drinking the blackberry here.
Peach water.
And then we also have carbonated,
Blackberry I was drinking this morning. It's also pretty good.
Thank you. Yeah, and the carbonated ones are in the different shaped bottle there. So,
when you were making the first couple batches and reducing the berries to that, to try to make this product, I bet you had no idea you would be making, I don't know how many bottles a month you're making, but probably a few.
No idea.
No idea. What was the challenge for other entrepreneurs who might want to build something that's actually a physical product? What sort of challenges did you have along that way that you can remember better?
I think it helps to sort of not be afraid of what's on the other end, right? As an entrepreneur, I've had, to your point earlier, I didn't think about, oh my gosh, there's all this competition out there.
Yeah.
I instead just stayed focused on my product and knew that I just had to get it down the field, right? And I thought, along the way, I want to make sure that I'm spending properly and I'm not doing something stupid. But, you know, worrying about your competition is a really psychologically difficult way to sort of lead your life.
Yep.
You know, you have to focus, and, you know, whether you're in technology or whether you're in a consumer product. And I think that the other thing is, this was helping me in my life, and it was a personal passion of mine to be able to change something that I saw as a problem.
Yeah.
And so...
And I think that's really key for entrepreneurs. If you don't have a passion for your own product, you're going to give up. Because every billionaire that I have ever met or talked with, I always ask them, what's the day you almost give up? And they always have a story.
Yeah.
Where they even Rackspace, our chairman said, I almost sold the company the week of 9/11, and that deal fell through.
Right.
And I might as well keep the company going. And it worked out.
Yeah.
Everybody has a bad day. And so if you don't have that passion, you're going to give up.
Totally.
Mm, right.
And I think also if you're doing a Me Too product, I've seen so many beverage companies while we've been
doing
this.
That's a lesson. And that was actually one of the reasons I wanted you on, because you're not a tech entrepreneur. I mean, you're not selling an app on
right,
the phone.
Right, right.
But so many entrepreneurs pitch me things in very crowded fields like travel or photo sharing or whatever. And Google was the 17th search engine, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it won. But it had something that was 10 times better than the competition.
Mm-hmm.
It was way better. This is way better, right?
Mm-hmm.
This has a differentiator that nobody else, I haven't seen any other water that's like this without sugar in it, right?
Right, and without the sweeteners too, because I think that's the key difference. There are other products out there that claim to be flavored water, but they have Splenda or Stevia.
And that makes me, I like Snapple, for instance, because I was heading down this path, and that seemed healthier than Coca-Cola. But Snapple has a lot of sweetener in it,
mm-hmm.
and it makes me feel bad.
Mm-hmm.
And this didn't. And I was like, the sweeteners are the key.
Yeah. And there's, you know, there's still a lot of discovery that has to be made on these sweeteners. But, you know, I've watched this now for many, many decades, and it's a... you know, the sweeteners keep going out of, going away and getting shelved for a reason. There's always a new sweetener, and it's frightening. And I think many of the sweeteners today actually trick your brain into thinking that you're hungry. And I know Coke and Pepsi have done many studies on this, and it's part of the reason why a Diet Coke today tastes much different and much sweeter than a Diet Coke of 20 years ago.
Yeah. Coke Zero, which we have over here, tastes like the old Coke.
Right.
But it's all sweeteners.
Yeah. And if you actually track it within a few hours, you'll be hungry again. And the question is whether your stomach really is hungry, or is your brain telling your stomach that you're hungry? And so I just decided I want to move away from sweeteners as much as possible. And if I'm going to crave sweet, if I want to have a cupcake, I'm going to have a cupcake. But today, I can't even eat a whole cupcake.
But I think the lesson for other entrepreneurs is, if you're going into a crowded space, you better be 10 times better. You better have something that makes you extraordinarily different than the other
guys.
Right? And maybe you still fail, but you have to have something where you can tell in 20 seconds what the difference is. And Google had it. I remember that first search very clearly, because they just asked put your favorite search
in. I remember that as well,
right? And it had no porn. I was like, how did you get rid of the porn? Then we spent an hour talking about how they got rid of the porn in my net meeting
so
site.
So funny.
Because I knew what the result set should be, and Alta Vista always had porn. Google comes along, and there was no porn. I'm like,
It's good.
Yeah. Because they had a differentiator. They had something that was better called PageRank.
That's
well,
great.
Thank you for coming in.
Thank
this
you.
Is really
yeah,
cool.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
You can get this. It's about a dollar something.
$1.69. It's nationwide at Whole Foods, a bunch of Starbucks, and most
and
conventional groceries, and on our website at drinkhint.com. And in San Francisco and the Bay Area, we actually have a local delivery program as well. So
cool.
If any offices are interested, too.
Very cool.
So thank you so much. Yeah, thanks, Robert. Appreciate it.